What's going on, guys? Talking to Jay Kim here with a review for Microsoft E3 2017 press conference, and yeah. So I'm only gonna go off the what I know. So pretty much everything they shown in that conference, everything they did show in that conference that kind of impressed me was only Dragon Ball FighterZ, Dragon Ball Z FighterZ. I have a PS4, so I don't need an Xbox One for that. Shadow War, Middle Earth. That kind of looked interesting, but I'm probably not gonna get it. What else? Sea of Thieves, nah. Days of Decay 2, nah. Metro Exodus, nah. Anthem looked really good, but EA, I don't play EA games other than Battlefield, so yeah. What else did it show? Assassin's Creed Origin, not really Assassin's Creed fan at all. Forza, no, not a fan of racing sims or stuff like that. The Xbox Scorpio, I mean not Xbox Scorpio, Xbox One X, cost $500, I believe. And yeah, did they show the release date? November 7th, I believe. Yeah, it released November 7th this year, $500. In terms of the Xbox One X power, yeah, it definitely has a lot going for it. A lot of power in it, and yeah. Oh yeah, they also show Code Vein, also got a PS4, that's also probably come to the PS4. So pretty much the two, and they showed another game. Yeah, the Black Desert. I think that's a exclusive to Xbox. I don't know if it's Microsoft RP, they didn't say much about it, but it's exclusive to Xbox, and yeah, it definitely seemed to be more so, you know, Japanese type of game, because the way it's how action packed it was and the character design and stuff in this MMO. So yeah, but I'm not really interested in a lot of MMO games. So pretty much the only game that kind of interests me was Dragon Ball FighterZ and Code Vein, which are most likely definitely coming to the PlayStation 4, so I really don't need an Xbox. So pretty much this conference was kind of lackluster to me because it didn't show anything that it would get me, you know, wanting an Xbox or wanting to like somehow get one. But yeah, maybe when it becomes super duper cheap, the Xbox One X, I'll probably get one and then see what they got, because I got an Xbox 360 like 2013, around the time it, you know, Xbox One was coming. So yeah, that's it for this review for Xbox One X at Microsoft E3 2017 press conference briefing, whatever you want to call it. And don't forget to leave a like, comment, subscribe, and tell me your thoughts below. How do you feel about it? And yeah, catch you guys next time. Peace.